I'm so very happy to see so many Sahaja Yogis are here now in America. And the program we have had the other day showed us clearly that Sahaja Yoga is getting very popular. And the way people got their realization in 5 minutes also showed that now we have touched that area of seekers who are honest and who are of a very high level spirituality. You are the ones who are the first Sahaja Yogis, we should say, or the foundation of the Sahaja Yoga in America. And thus, we have to understand our own responsibility. As it is, Vishuddhi Chakra is responsible for the whole world. But the people in Vishuddhi Chakra have to be like Ganas, they have to be very responsible, extreme, much more than any other country in the whole world. And the problem is, somehow I found, I don't know about the future, that sense of responsibility, yet not felt among Sahaja Yogis, that they are responsible for the whole world, not only for America or only for New York or only for Yonkers. Sitting down here, you are responsible for the whole world. If you understand this, that the main quality of Vishuddhi Chakra is responsibility. I always say it's on my shoulder. I take it on my shoulder, meaning what? That I take the responsibility. But this sense of responsibility has to come to you very clearly. I felt America is so far away. But if they could come and see in Russia, how the Russians are behaving towards Sahaja Yoga, they'll be amazed. I've been coming to America since so many years. Perhaps we should say this is the first country I visited. But here, the sense of responsibility for Sahaja Yoga has not grown. While in a country like Russia and Eastern Bloc, I've been only 4 years there hardly, and you should see how they feel responsible. Now in Russia, Sahaja Yoga has spread up to Siberia. Now in Siberia, they don't live for themselves only or for their ashram. There they have got a place called Novashibir, which is mostly inhabited by scientists because so many scientists were thrown away by Tsars and later on by the communists and were exiled into that place. Now these people sitting there tried to find out what is spirituality. How do we get to spirituality? What is the way we can reach our spirituality? No quarrel, no fights, no stupid things that people do, no domination, no ego. I was there only about a week back, I should say, more than a week. And last day before going, there came a scientist. His eyes really were just like ocean, were absolutely beautiful. And he was supposed to be one of the greatest scientists of Russia, having a very big job of his own. And he didn't talk about me much to others. He just wanted to see me. When he came, he just took my hand and kissed it, bowed to me. I saw in his eyes ocean of spirituality, ocean. He must have been about 35 or 40 years of age. Can't say his age because he was so much shining and bright. And he told me, "I know everything about Mother." I said, "What do you know?" "That you are the incarnation of God on this earth to save us." "How did you find out?" He said, "I have made a machine by which I can measure energy fields." "Of course, I can't measure your energy field. But I took a small photograph of your and measured the energy field. And I found it was 700 raised to power some millions and then raised to power some billions. That's why I don't understand this guy." Just imagine. And he created the whole idea of his proposed experiments for which he had come to take permission from me. He said, "You just touch this glass, Mother, just touch it." And he had brought a machine. I touched the glass and his machine went on revolving like that. I was myself surprised. He said, "Just touching the glass, it's happening." He had a machine with him, a little machine which he had. "This is portable," he said. So I said, "What is the permission you want?" He said, "I want to use your photograph on a satellite. And from the satellite, I want to project your photograph through electromagnetic force. And wherever in the global region it will be put, you will see it will change. It will change people, it will change all flora, fauna, and also ecological problems will be solved. Will you give me permission for that?" I said, "Of course, why not?" The level of scientists in that country is so great. Here I don't think we can get hold of any scientist because their ego is keeping them hanging in the air. The another thing which I was surprised that in Novashivir, when Yogi told them that Mother has told us that in our brain there are pithas of these chakras, they were so much surprised. They said, "We can verify. We have machines to verify." So they called Dr. Khan. And when Dr. Khan went there, he was amazed. They had a machine. So, he said, "Now let us put attention to Sri Mataji." The whole brain became reddish. "Then let us put attention to heart." Here, it became a red spot. "Then to Muladhar," was here. "Then to Nabhi on both the places. Then to Vishuddhi." It was proved. What I have said, they have proved it. And so many Americans are trying to get them to this country. They say, "We don't want to come. We don't want to do any more science. We want to do meta-science, spirituality." There are 250 scientists in Novashivir where I could not go because we had a puja. Now see the difference. Here I come, the quarrels between husband and wife. There is a father, mother. All such petty, nonsensical things are going on. So your own brothers and sisters in another country are doing so much of experimentation, spreading of such. Imagine, how will I go to Siberia, out of question. But from Siberia, I don't know how many thousands came. They are all well educated, very well equipped, extremely well behaved. In their style, in their behavior, you see that there is such a lot of spirituality already built. Then I went to Ukraine. Ukraine is a place where they had this, you know, Chernobyl problem. First time when I had gone, there were people who had come to my program. They had their fingers joined like this, noses turned like this, all kinds of things. And the legs and feet were in a very funny way. With all that, they came to the program, and this time the hall was so full, there were at least 10 times more people than we are here, maybe more. And outside were standing, they couldn't get in. They were sitting in the passages, the 3-tier on the ground and 3 more. Everything filled to the inch. And I was amazed at their spirituality. Everyone got realization in 5 minutes. What a level of people, what a level. But then I found out that in Ukraine, they already had the knowledge of Kundalini and of the primordial mother. They call her Aditi. In India also we call her Aditi. And they used to make paintings of her. Then they had paintings made of Ajna Chakra, of Muladhara. Very clear. In those days, before Christ, 3,000 years before Christ. So basically in them, from where? Somewhere, this knowledge had come. You are very advanced people here, supposed to. You are very well equipped, and people think Americans are the top for everything. But look at these people from Ukraine and from Russia. They were worshipping the primordial mother 3,000 before Christ, and when Christianity came, they suppressed it. All clearly written down. And when people wrote about it also, these Christians there, they're called as Orthodox Christians, they tried to kill them, arrest them. Despite all those problems, they stuck on. And I was surprised that even today there are books and magazines about it. So I was thinking somebody like Vachindranath, who went all over the world, must have gone with his disciple Gorakhnath there, because they were Nathpanthis. They knew about Kundalini. But actually they have shown the Aditi, the mother, with a Kundalini in her stomach. Can you imagine? All these things were done long time back. And that's why basically they are very spiritual. Firstly, they are very introspective and very spiritual. And all the time they are asking, Mother, are we going to be all right? Are we all right? Have we really taken our ascent? Like that, those questions which were absolutely different from what you see in the West. In whatever field they are, if he's a doctor, he'll try to find something. A dentist, then they'll try to find something related to surgery. And they said there are so many coincidences that you cannot explain how this has worked out, how. So I said, well, what did you do? He said, we just decided that we should now try to propagate Sahaja Yoga and to analyze it and put it on such a concrete way that Nobody can doubt it. No scientist can doubt it. So we are at that level to see somebody so much higher. And then we have also understanding how we can rise up to that point. How we have to work it out. Now the pettiness with which you suffer can come in many categories, which is nothing but stupidity. One of them is that this idea of leadership, which is greatest stupidity you could ever think of. I am just befooling you by saying you are a leader, nothing. It's just a myth. You don't believe me in that. If I call you the leader, you must know that mother is trying to test me. And others also, those who are trying this power game of becoming leaders. Nothing of the kind. There is no one who you can really say is the leader of Sahayoga, except that I had to have some people to communicate, so we got them leaders. It doesn't mean that if they become leader, when they go to heaven, they will get a right royal reception, nothing of the kind. All will be going in the same manner. See, this is all created by Maya. Now, people are striving to become leader and I really feel like laughing. Those who will try are climbing a mountain which doesn't exist. Where are you climbing? Where are you going? It doesn't exist. There's no mountain. It's all straightforward road. So this is also a sign of complete stupidity. Are we to say that all the stupids are born in this country? Are we to feel that all stupidity has trickled down to this country through Hudson River? Are we to believe that all intelligence has vanished into ego? Once you realize it is stupidity, it's best to stand before the mirror and make fun of yourself. Also, I've noticed with all the writers of Russia, they have been very introspective. Even a hero will think 10 times, why I'm loving this lady, why I'm doing this. Even the woman, if she's in love, she'll think, why am I doing this, should I do it or not, is proper or not. Is it something in my head that is making me do it? You see, absolutely clearly they go on introspecting themselves. Even now I find the Russians are like. So we have to now start a new tradition. In that tradition, we have to introspect. Introspect yourself. There's another way is you shouldn't try to see the defects of others, but to see what's wrong with them. Where do you fail? Why do you fail? Why you cannot propagate Sahayoga? What is the reason? What has failed you? Because it's only possible when you think you are responsible. Not leader, but responsible. This is the country where we have had the greatest fights for leadership and all leaders have now jumped into river huts. So this kind of stupid idea should be given up and we should introspect to see how much stupid we are. I had started believing that the special blessing of Maya is on Americans, that they are all stupid. I used to think, I must confess, in the beginning. Then I met you all and I realized it's not that bad. Because I met so many important people, ambassadors, this and that and all that in England, I used to wonder, what's wrong with them? They used to behave like young boys of 20 years. In Hindi we call it gadha pachisi, means at 25 you are a donkey. And the way they used to pass jokes, and I said, they have no dignity, nothing, such high positions they are having, what do they talk about? And they would stand out by that, you know. They said, ah, we are smart, you know. They would wink at everyone, they would do all kinds of nonsensical things, which normally a 20-year-old boy might do anywhere, once in a while. But they were all like that. They thought they were very young, and they would walk, you see, with very great smartness, you see, like young boys. To them, it should be very fast, and a bowler is about to bowl or some sort of a thing. It was really unbelievable that these people occupy such high position in the government. How could they be so irresponsible? But when I met you all, then I really felt that no, there are very good people also. This comparison you can today also see between you and these people. They'll argue for anything. They'll talk about anything, like for Freud, they were fighting it. Freud told us something very new. So I've written in my book, so I said, all right, you have eaten all kinds of food before, but you have not eaten the table, what about eating the table? So everything absurd, everything vulgar, everything low level was justified. I don't blame you. All these stupid people were born here and they wrote books. They were the ones who were generals. They were in charge. I mean, I can't understand. You see this fellow not. You can, 1 minute you look at him and you will know he's a lunatic. And they gave him so much time, so much explanation. I mean, I can't understand. And the idea about spirituality is like somebody comes and tells you something absurd. It's new. It's new. So do it. Now they say that you shave your head. All right, we'll shave that. They say, no, you grow your hair, or they'll grow. As if they have no personality of their own, they don't think much about themselves, they have no respect of themselves. Even in those parties, they used to tell me, ah, have you been to this guru? I said, no, I'm sorry, I have not. Nowadays it's bargain, better do it. Level of understanding of spirituality was also so low of these people who were so highly placed. And I was amazed, how could they do such things with such big position? There was one fellow who was quite highly placed. He used to always look out for me whenever there was a party. So CP said, why does he look out for you? I said, you know, he wants to eat a lot. And here the food they serve in England is not sufficient for him. So he sits next to me, so he can share all my food, you see, that's why he always does. I eat very little. So much interest in food. Then when I was not there, he would go and sit with CP, because he knew the secret, he used to pass his food to him. So much interest in food. And himself was in such a big position. And what was he boasting about? That I come on a bicycle, on a half pant, to office. I said, why do you go on a half pant? It's better for a bicycle. But why do you come in a bicycle? It's better for health. But after all, you are such a big officer. If you are going to your office, you should go on a motor car. You have such a big car. And then this bicycle, you can do it in some sports club or something. Out of proportion. Where are you going? What work you have to do? Why don't you understand? And he is the one who used to eat like a glutton, I tell you. But he was thin like this, absolutely thin like this. So I concluded must be worms in his stomach or whatever it is. But I used to have pity for him because he's always very hungry. Now, the attention, if it is on food, attention, if it is on money, attention, if it is on so-called power of leadership and all that, know that it will make you stupid. Anybody who goes, I am the leader of this, all right, all right, very good. You've known one like him, you see? That's what you have to react. Because if you say that I am the leader of this and this, itself shows that you are a stupid fool. Isn't it? Because if you know its stupidity, all this mother is making a fool out of us. Why should you say I am the greatest fool? Why should you yourself boast of yourself? Even any boasting is a sign of a stupid fool, you know, or a mad lunatic person. Once our Prime Minister went to one lunatic asylum, and he met one who was sane to talk to. So he asked him, who are you? He said, I am Jawaharlal Nehru. He said, who is Jawaharlal Nehru? He said, I am the one who is the Prime Minister of India. You'll be all right. I used to say the same, you stay here for 5-6 months, you'll be all right. So all such bombastic talking, those people who do, you should just know, I'm telling you, certified lunatics or certified fools. And once this goes, this stupidity into your head, you will be no more a surgeon, no more. Whole spirituality will come out and you will be left high and dry. Anyone who boasts like that is worse, but even if you think like that, is no good. Not on the proper lines. So because of this ego, you don't understand your responsibility. When you argue also, I've seen people say, but I am the leader of this, I am the leader of this. Start looking at them. How can they live together? How can they be collective, which is the quality of humanity? I just saw this tree, see how many there are. Of different varieties, different qualities, of different nature, absolutely different. But how they are living together? They all share the same sunlight. They don't quarrel. The tree doesn't say, I must fall onto another one somehow because he thinks so. One thing is, I cannot tell these trees that you are the leader. Only I can befool human beings. This is the main thing is, please be careful. Don't be befooled by what I tell you, all right? As because if I see somebody stupid, I do pamper his ego so that it bursts forever and he gets rid of his nonsensical ego. But that's not my job. Point is that I want you to be like Russians. They don't have any ego, nothing. They don't have any problem. It's so easy to deal with them because they know what I am and they know what they are. You cannot befool them, no. Anyone, whether he is the biggest scientist or the highest ranking official, or the highest personality in any field, you cannot be fooled. They are so humble. And the Chinese the same. You have to learn a lot from Chinese also. They are so sensitive to spirituality. So beautiful they are, so humble. You cannot tell them that you've done something, good work or anything. They say, no, so much to be done still, it's all right. You are saying it in your goodness, but we know our weaknesses. But in America, everything is fixed and also your ego is fixed like that. And the slightest blow, you blow it off. And become so much one that no trace of that drop should be there. I am no more an individual. I am the ocean. And this collectivity has to grow in this country, not in Russia. Everything is growing like a cancer, you know. Supposing the nose starts coming out from here, and the mouth starts out coming up from here, what will happen? This country had to have this capacity. This country had to do this. While it's done by Russia, I don't even know their language. But what you find here, only the false gurus are accepted. And in Sahaja Yoga, people do not know how to respect their self-life. So busy with their ego. So much impressed by themselves. The whole atmosphere is such a competition, perfection. It's a big professional achievement even in Sahaja Yoga. Sahaja Yoga is not a profession. Because profession means individuality of a drop. This is a collective work. Means what? Sahaja Yoga is a surrender. It's not a profession, it's a surrender. You are very intelligent people, but I think little more than normal. So all of you start thinking on your own sometimes and bring problem. But the difference of problem of Russia and this place is so much. Somebody told me, Mother, you must come and live here, it will be a good idea. I will, I don't mind. But every third step if you meet somebody who is immoral, fifth step who is a stupid fool, and the seventh feet you find a person who is about to give a big lecture on spirituality. So what to do? Now you cannot be one of them, I must assure you. You are not one of them. But sometimes the atmosphere is so much full of speed and so much full of this ego that you do develop this ego business very fast. So quick, you know. And whenever I see that, I get real fright. What's going to happen to America? It's not your country. It's not the country of your government. It's the country of collectivity. Collective personality. So now, the other day we had so many people who got their realization in 5 minutes. That means they are seekers. They are great seekers, they are frustrated, they got it without any problem. But to make them understand Sahaja Yoga, to make them absolutely an ocean out of the drops, all that, which is the most important thing you have to do. You have to see that you make Americans understand and realize what is the greatness of their personality. Why are they on this earth of spirituality and of collectivity? Why? Why you were born here? For what purpose? You must evaluate. It's not so. They'll get attached to, identification is too much, they get attached to their children so much, if not. Then they will get attached to so-called their power, then they get attached to their house, then they get attached to their grounds, then to the stones, I don't know what they get attached to. You have to be that great. For that, complete detachment has to be brought in your life. That is the most important thing. This kind of an identity with this, this and this and this is not going to make you grow, and if you don't grow, Sahaja Yoga won't grow. It will keep a very, very low level profile. To get that high level profile, you have to do one thing, is to surrender your ego. The greatest problem of America is Mr. Ego. This ego must be controlled. I will tell you, it's very simple. Every day, if you use the way we have to clear out our ego, every day, you can get rid of it. Because the whole speed, atmosphere, competition, all is to pamper your ego. I have even seen some advertisement talking about ego. You see, this cigarette, if you smoke, your ego will be pampered. Can you imagine? And people buy that kind of a nonsense because they think it's great, you know, our ego will be pampered. As if their ego is not already pampered. So this ego business comes to people because there's no introspection. When there is no introspection, you see, one develops this ego. I am something great. Now say sitting down here, if you start saying, I am great, I am great, I am great. Do you become great? You cannot. There's a story about a frog you must have heard, who was in a well and used to think, no, no, I'm everything, I'm the best, I'm that. Somebody told me him that, have you seen a cow? What is a cow? It's a very big animal compared to him. I can also become big, why not? I will. And starts growing, growing till it burst out. So this is what it is, we have to understand that this ego business is the real, real, real problem of America. So now you have to surrender. Now surrender to whom? It's like this. That if you say you are seekers, I mean you are seekers of everything. You are seekers of money, seekers of power, seekers of this, seekers of that. But if you are seeker of truths, then just face yourself and know yourself and know the truth that you cannot be a person of any value if you have this artificial ego on your head like a big balloon. Never. This ego has to be brought down. Absolutely. And all of you should try to bring it down by doing some sort of a special method of searching within yourself. You have to. I don't know how to detach yourself and see for yourself. It's rather a difficult thing, because ego is very satisfied. This is the biggest problem. Ego gives great satisfaction. And with that ego, you see, you react. And reaction has become like a sort of a matter of right. React. I don't like it, I don't like that, I don't like that. So who are you? If somebody says, I don't like you, finished. First of all, you should start saying, I don't like myself. Let's start like that. Why? Because all my life is centered around this, I'm doing that stupidity, another stupidity. How can I like myself? I am the spirit. Then you will start growing, because this conditioning keeps you down. But somebody asked me, who is interested in growing mother? I said, why? They're not. They're now surgery. Finished. So there's going to be a great ship coming down to take all the surgeries to enter into the kingdom of God. So why should we introspect? You have to grow. Even the stage is not there that is confirmed that you will enter into the kingdom of God. You have to give up the stupid idea of ego. But what should replace it? What will replace it? Is love and compassion. That two people can use it with the ego. Like I tell somebody now, this fellow is not all right. So, but Father, you know, he is, I love him. If you love him, better correct him. If you really love, have courage to tell him that this is wrong with you. If you are continuing with this love story, then you must correct that person. And all these complicated, you know, such complicated things there are with this ego, that you just don't know how to solve the problem sometimes if somebody comes to you with that ego. So first is to introspect and find out, why am I egoistical? What have I done? You'll be surprised. I don't know what his ego is. I really. I've just seen some things, but to be very frank, I don't know what people are egoistic. Like sometimes you start seeing my Jai, I also say Jai. I don't think it's me you are saying Jai. Just say, all right, they are saying Jai, not say Jai. Because I don't know why you say Jai. I don't know why. What have I done? Why are you praising me? I just don't understand. If somebody says, thank you very much, Mother, I don't understand why they're thanking. For what? What have I done? See, this ego is the one that records everything. That this is what it is, I am such and I am such, I am such. All falsehood. But if I don't have such a record in your head, you cannot feel ego. If somebody says, you are very good looking, immediately the balloon starts. Why is he saying? Maybe he wants some money, maybe he wants to use you for some purpose, maybe he's praising because he knows you are a stupid fool. So why? Accept such a remark as something great, you know. And in this way, we lose ourselves completely. Let us have a command of ourselves. Do we know ourselves? I know I am that, I know I am born like that, I know all these things are there, so what? I mean, I didn't achieve anything. You at least achieved. I never achieved anything, I was just like that. So why to be conscious of it? That I am this, I am nothing. Because whatever I am. Now supposing this wood says, oh, I am wood. So what? You are wood after all. As simple as that. As simple as that. So, see, these complications of your mind should be reduced, otherwise your attention will never improve, and what will happen is that you will not grow. And the dwarfs, you know, we'll have all the dwarfs here. I want to show to Russians that you are quite capable of growing. And you are quite capable of looking after your country. Your own president, his wife, all of them are funny people. Try to talk nonsense sometimes, absolutely. Can't understand. What business they have got to talk about other countries when their own country is suffering so? There's no introspection, there's no understanding what's wrong with your own country, and you start talking about other countries, this is wrong with them, that is wrong with them. So, in this atmosphere, when you find a whole lot of people have this problem of ego, you can only supersede them, only shine out, you can only save them by absolutely getting rid of your ego, absolutely, 100%, in every way. You'll see, you'll feel much lighter. Imagine, you are hanging in the air, you don't know where you are going to land. How can you feel secure? As they say, stand on your legs. Just like that. Stand on your legs. So now, Sahaja Yoga is progressing very well, very fast, everywhere in the whole world. They gave me a doctorate, they did this, they are trying their little best now to give me a Nobel Prize also. Because only the Nobel Prize can put these egoistical people, all right. So they are working very hard to get me a Nobel Prize. All that is to show that people will never accept me unless and until I have some sort of a brand on my head. But it is important. In this world, one has to have some sort of a brand if you have to survive. Everything. So, for you also, it is important that you have to have the brand of Sahaja Yoga. But in Sahaja Yoga, if you have the brand, it doesn't work out. You have to have in reality that power of yoga within you. You can do a lot, I know, because you stand on land of Sri Krishna and his palm. Don't need anything else. Don't need any machinery, nothing. But only realize your responsibility, what we are doing for Sahaja, for ourselves. How are we behaving? What is our style? How are we spreading Sahaja? Please try. If you can really introspect, you will find that you will feel that we haven't done much for Sahaja Yoga that we could have done. Busy with yourself, with your own activities. But unless and until you do for Sahaja Yoga something, you have no meaning at all, you have no identity. If you can develop this beautiful reflective nature by which you just reflect about yourself and not about others, you'll be amazed how much will change. Even a simple meditation people don't do. You get them an ashram, there they fight. Do what you like, ends up into something funny. I didn't want to talk to you about something unpleasant all the time. It's not a very good idea. But I feel that you should now awaken to the fact what is your responsibility as Americans. Very important. Extremely important. And once you realize that, you can do so many things because you have got the power. You have the divine power. But you must awaken and shed off this horrible thing called ego, which makes you a monkey. I have seen this is the only problem you have. There's not much conditioning. But this ego is the only problem. You don't respect anyone, you don't respect this motherland, you don't respect even your self-realization. So this point today, we have to know that we cannot afford to have this ego anymore on our heads. We just are not going to have it. We are going to humble down. And we are going to see to things through our humility. Once, you see, these things work out, you will be the most important persons for even the divine to deliver the goods. May God bless you. As it is, we have now, I am awaiting, lots of Americans will be coming. And what will convince them of you is your humility and your good manners. Very important. If these two things they see in you, they will change. I am sure they will change. Not to be aggressive with them.